How far would you go for the love of your life? Our next guest retraced the footsteps of a legendary British explorer for love and glory. In his book, Crossing the Heart of Africa, adventure writer Gillian Smith takes readers on an unforgettable 4,500-mile journey as he proves his commitment to marriage. And Gillian Smith joins us now. Welcome, Gillian.
This
is great. All right, so this actually started out as an adventure book, then it turned out into a more of a love story.
Yes, it did, actually. It's actually two stories in one, or three when you count all the story plots. First is my trip across Africa I took in 2007, and then I was retracing the route of a British explorer from 1898, and it's also the story of both of our relationships, actually.
All right, so why did you choose him? This is, of course, we're talking about Ewart Grogan.
Yes, I was in a bit of a predicament about in 2007. I was meant to get married, I was engaged to be married, and I was still terrified by the idea of commitment. And then I heard about this British explorer named Ewart Grogan who had actually crossed Africa from one end to the other to win the hand of the woman he loved. And I was inspired to do the same thing.
And this is a picture of Ewart Grogan.
Yes.
And he did it because the stepfather of the woman he wanted to marry said you couldn't marry her because you haven't proven yourself.
Yes, her name was Gertrude Watt. She lived in New Zealand, and she was actually a descendant of James Watt, who invented the steam engine. So she was rich.
And there she is. She's beautiful as well.
Yes, she was. And Grogan was head over heels in love with her, and she was with him. But her stepfather was a little jealous, and he said, well, what have you done to prove yourself worthy of my daughter's hand? And Grogan said, well, how about if I walk from one end of Africa to the other? And he did.
And he did. But it was not an easy task. What you did in 2 months, he did in 2.5 years.
Yes. He walked about 4,500 miles from Sudan to South Africa. He walked and he also took some boats. And I took 2 months. And I took pretty much every mode of transportation I could find, from buses, boats, bicycles, motorcycles, a little plane flight, and just about everything I could do.
And he did it by foot for the most part, right?
Yes.
And of course, he experienced a lot more things than you did.
Yes. He almost
cannibalism.
Died. Yes, he found everything there you could find in Africa. He was sick most of the time. He was burning up with fever. He had malaria. He literally had to flee for his life from cannibals for a few days in what's now the Congo. And he got tossed into a tree by an elephant at one point. And by the end of his trip, he was literally dragging himself along on his hands and knees.
But he kept going to Cairo.
He kept going all the way to Cairo. And then he sent a telegraph back to Gertrude and said, I made it. I hope you're still waiting for me. I still love you. And she sent one back a few days later that said, yes, I'm still waiting for you.
What a love story. Okay, so what happened to you? It took you 2 months. What did you learn about yourself as you were going through your own personal journey?
Well, my position was a little different from his. I was in love, and Laura was waiting for me, and I had this terrifying fear of commitment. I think.
You just weren't sure about it? I mean, I know this is a natural feeling. I mean, a lot of people go through this.
I'm a guy, a lot of us struggle with this.
But you chose to take on this journey, to discover what it is you needed to learn about yourself.
Yeah, it was almost like I had to go as far away as I could to find out what I was leaving behind, in a way. And, of course, I realized that, and after 2 months, I realized this is far enough. I need to go home, and this is what I want to do. I've known all along Laura is the woman for me, and she was waiting for me at the airport.
And you also, let's take a look at what we have here, this picture. This is your journey.
Yes.
You started out where?
I started out in Johannesburg, South Africa, and then went to the coast of Mozambique, and then followed the chain of lakes and volcanoes north all the way to southern Sudan.
All right, what was the toughest challenge for you?
I think the toughest challenge, well, first of all, the loneliness. I was traveling alone most of the way, and it was not easy or happy traveling. It was public transportation, bouncy trucks, bouncy buses, pretty bad hotels. This was actually one of the overnight ferries that I took on one of the lakes. This is in Lake Malawi. So I think that the loneliness and being away from Laura and just the drudgery of travel in the backcountry of Africa was the toughest part.
And that really taught you that, well, you learned anyway, that you couldn't live without her.
Yes, I did, yes. Yes, and after 2 months, I made it up to as far as southern Sudan, and I had to make a decision how far I was going to press on, whether I was willing to risk my life like Grogan was or not. And I realized I wasn't. I realized where I needed to be was back home where I'd left.
So we need more guys to read this book, don't we?
I think we do, yes. And women, and they're women too.
Yes, I think a lot of people would learn about relationships through this, in this book. Now, the third plot, of course, is Africa.
Yes.
And one line that resonated with me was the one line that somebody said to you in the book, and it's, Africa is crying always.
Yeah, that was definitely one of the more poignant moments of the trip. I mean, I was bumping into everyday people in Africa the entire way, every day, on the buses, in the hotels. And we have, here in the West, we have such a specific picture of Africa as being a place of suffering and AIDS orphans and everything. And it was really, I think, eye-opening for me to see how much of the continent, at least the part that I was through, was just people, normal people going about their lives, incredibly friendly, welcoming to me almost everywhere I went, and just seeing what daily life was like in a place that's so different from ours.
Well, we're just glad you survived your journey, and there's a fabulous picture of you and your wife, and this is your wedding day?
This is our wedding day in Sundance, Utah in October 2007.
You look so happy, and you have a daughter, is that right?
Yes, we do. Our daughter, Ivy, is just over 2 years old now.
Well, what's next for you?
I'm thinking about a few more book ideas, and in the meantime, I'm staying pretty close to home.
All right. Again, the book is Crossing the Heart of Africa. Julian Smith, thanks so much for being here. We really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. And don't go away. There's more Connecticut Style right after this.